Hi everyone, welcome back. So in the previous video we tried to connect to the MongoDB database. So before doing that, what I want is let's have a Docker setup. So we will have a two containers, Node.js and MongoDB container, so that our Node.js container would be able to talk to MongoDB. We are not going to do a local installation for that. So for that, what I will do is I will just copy one required files, which is a Docker file, Docker compose and Docker ignore from one of my previous project. And we'll try to just put it here. Docker file will be a simple one. Here how we are starting the project using npm run start. So Docker file should be npm run start. We are exposing port 3000 and env also has a port 3000. index.js has port 4000. Let's make it configurable process.env.port. process.env.port. So port is now configurable. We'll be using 3000 port passed from here. Environment is development. This can be some random secret key we are using. We'll be using in future. So it's index.js. We have Docker file, Docker compose. Docker compose contains, I think, MySQL. So what we will do, we don't need MySQL. We need only MongoDB. So for now, we'll remove it. So in services, we have a node and we have MongoDB. DB data, there is no one mounting DB data. We have only Mongo data, and in Node.js container, it depends on Mongo here, and we can just do Docker compose up, and we should be good. This is the Docker file, npm install, npm run start, 3000 is a port. Let's see. First Docker compose build. So it will do the installation for this project first, the node container, and it will be using the predefined image for the Mongo, which I think I already have, so we don't need to pull the Mongo image from the Docker hub, and it is exposing this port. So in the env file, when you wanted to connect to the MongoDB, you will be using Mongo as a host name. So here we can see Mongo local, okay, sorry. Here it will be Mongo, host is Mongo 27017 development. So here we should be good. Our Docker compose file should have two services. It will look for the Docker file. So we have a Docker file already there. It will just, so the instructions in this is it will install the latest Node.js version. Working directory it will set for the container. Then copy all the existing code in the current working directory to the container. npm install and npm run start. So let's see this Docker compose up. It is starting, the Mongo has started. Now it is doing the Node.js boot up. So Node.js server node 1. So we can also check the containers running here. Here GraphQL server node container is running. It is actually just compiling it and seeing if everything is good. Okay, here we have index.js, and what recent code we have updated is now we are actually asking Mongo to connect first. If Mongo we are able to connect, then we will start the server. So I think we encountered in the catch block, seems like. Okay, I think we connected. Connection accepted to global Mongo service. Server is ready. Here also we can add a message, something to show, okay, MongoDB connection has started. So we should be sure, okay, everything is good. So once we, now we are able to connect to the MongoDB, now in our resolvers, you will be able to write a MongoDB queries through the model, like model.findById, find all. All these queries we should be able to write. So here we were writing our resolvers in the application. So here we have models, resolvers. So this is a base resolver. Now in the resolver we created user.js and message.js. Right here we will just do a type definition. So in the resolvers, like user, here we will be doing a definition for all the queries we have written. So I will just try to create a baseline of this, export default, and here we will be defining the query for the user, which will be kencats. Okay, so what all queries we have written? First of all the queries we should be covering here. So if you just see extend type query, here we have these three queries: users, user and me. These three queries, so we'll be just putting all the queries here. Users will be fetching the users from the database, and you already know it accepts different arguments like parent or root, all the arguments which we are passing in the body and payload, and here we will be passing the data source that we will configure in our next video, that how we can configure our MongoDB database. And what we are doing, return this await data source dot, here we will be just making like user dot find, that's it. So what it will do, it will be able to return us the data. Another query is user, which is based on ID, so async, and here we accepted all these argument, parent, comma, argument. So from argument I will capture ID and the data source. Now what we can do is we can return await data source dot like user if we are able to access. I'm not sure if this is a right way, but we will be setting the data source in our main.js file, and here we will be accessing it. And another thing is same query we have for me, which will I think return my own data. And what we are doing here is parent argument data source comma me. So in this context we can set few things while bootstrapping the application itself. So here what we can check is if me is available. This is what like you are logged in, right, and you wanted to set your user data for every request, then you can put that data in the context so everyone will be able to access it. Okay, is there an error? Yeah, so what we defined all the queries for the users, right? In the similar fashion we'll be defining the mutation and subscription. Here this is the query. Now we can just change it to mutation. Right, and then subscription. So I will just writing this baseline, and then we will explore more on that. So what we are doing is in the mutation we will be doing a sign up, sign in, all these methods are there. If we just see what all we have defined in the user, extend type mutation, users, user and me. I think it should be, we haven't defined the mutation correctly, it should be sign up. Okay, login, all these methods will be here. Sign up will return a user, single user. Login will return a user. So all these methods we'll just fix this mutation. Here you can also have update user, which will also return a user entity, and delete user. First of all we are covering this particular use case, and here you have to provide some argument for this, like delete user ID is of type ID, which is required. Update user, here you will be passing the payload. I will not be passing it here, but in the sign up you will be passing all the different arguments, username, password, email, and all these things. You can put them in the comma separated. Like these are all the arguments this particular in the mutation we are accepting. So if I just define the mutation correctly, delete user should return boolean. I mean, we have deleted the user or not. Update user will return a user. Here we are allowing, okay, you can just enter a username only, which is of type string and is required. In the login, you will be passing not ID, you will be passing the username and password, simple, which is of type string required. Password, which is of type string required. Once user is logged in, you will be returning a token, not user. It is not correct. And sign up. So in the sign up, you might be passing a lot of things. So I will just try to write it. Username is of type string. This is required. Then we have an email of type string. This is also required. And we have a password. Just one thing, you don't need to just, if you are changing the line, then you don't need to put a comma. But here we are writing in the single line, username and password. You can put a comma and we are returning token. Here it is returning user. So now these are the mutations for the user entity. And now same entities, same mutations, we can do the implementation here. What actually will happen when the sign up, login, update user, delete user will happen. So here we will be accessing the MongoDB queries to update, create, delete, and all these things. Okay, that we will cover in the coming video because it will be lengthy.